These are my accommodations for tonight. This is the Koei house, I think, and Lake Yamanakaka is one of the five Fuji lakes. Yeah, so it's just a nice big room with a tatami mat and some futons. It's pretty comfortable. There's like two pads though, so that's probably why it's comfortable. Yeah, so, and I'll just kind of, I won't go through the house making a video, but it's a very big Japanese style house, like an old Japanese style house, and on the second floor there's a big huge staircase that goes up here, and I'll add pictures. So there's like a bathroom, there's bathrooms downstairs, and there's like a shower room, and like a sink. That's like a, it's a very, I don't know, it's almost like a, it's kind of like a dorm is what it feels like, a dorm, or maybe like a barracks almost. Right here, there's some power in the room, so yeah, you can tell it's kind of old house, there's not a lot of power outlets. There's like a heating place, yeah, that's pretty much it. There's a nice outside garden too. Very, very Japanese style. I like it. HadesOmega. All right, HadesOmega here. It's the third day. This is the third day. Yeah, it's the third day of my Japan riding trip, 2016. And let me see what my plan today is to ride around Mount Fuji clockwise. Whether I do it, you know, at night or in the day is a good question. Depends on how much stuff I do along the way. I plan to go to a couple places on the way and do a couple things. So I'd probably be by the time. So I'm gonna wind up at Kawaguchiko, and that's like the next lake over from here. And so I'm gonna start here and then end up going the long way around Mount Fuji is what I'm doing. Hopefully it doesn't take too long to get around Mount Fuji, but because I want to do a lot of stuff. You know, there's a lot of stuff. There's kind of a lot of stuff to do around Mount Fuji, but honestly, I'm probably just gonna spend a lot of time taking pictures of Mount Fuji going around it, because the views here are like incredible. So this is called what's called the Fuji Five Lakes area, and it's five lakes around Mount Fuji. I'm gonna try to visit them all. So, good times. I'll let you know how it goes.
HadesOmega. Okay, here's HadesOmega here. I'm heading out from the Koei house. This is where I stayed last night. Nice little guest house. Wow, man, that clutch really snatched it. When it's cold, it's snatchy. Yeah, something wrong with the clutch on this bike. It's not adjusted properly. Anyway, here we go. I'm doing some dirt riding. Is there a light there? I didn't see a light. Hey, Lake Yamanakako, free parking. Not around here. Oh, my Fuji's behind us. Oh, I was looking at the wrong direction.
All right, HadesOmega here. That's funny. So I thought Mount Fuji was like over here where the lake is, but it's actually behind. It was behind me the whole time. I was like, where's Mount Fuji? And like, it's right there. Anyway, yeah, so I just wanted to point out that the FJ09 or the MT09 Tracer is a pretty sexy looking bike. I dig the looks. I like it. Honestly, what it kind of reminds me of is a Suzuki V-Strom. Kind of like, the headlights look like, look V-Strom-ish, like, and then, kind of like the accents, you know, the little grills and stuff. It kind of reminds me of the, you know, the MT-07 or the, the Super Tenere. It looks like this kind of reminds me of a Super Tenere. So if like the Super Tenere and the V-Strom had like a kind of distant cousin, this would probably be the bike. I'll do a little quick walk around for you. I'm kind of close to the road here, so I'm gonna get one in the back.
Around Lake Yamanakako area. This is what the lovely town of Yamanakako looks like. There's some military vehicles, check that out. Nice. So there's a big JGSDF base around here. So we'll probably see a lot of military vehicles today on the southern part of Mount Fuji. Yeah, because there's a lot of bases there. Pretty cool. So here we are, Japan Day 3. This is pretty much my last touring day. And tomorrow, go home. Go home to Tokyo, where it's not fun to ride. So right now, I'm headed to Fuji Speedway is where I'm going. So it is very cold. It's 8 degrees Celsius right now. Yeah, so I'm headed to the famous Fuji Speedway. I don't know if it'll be open. It's almost 9 o'clock. There it is! Fuji-san! Woo! People just kind of just stop here and take a picture. You know what? I'm going to do the same thing. Alright, sorry. It was just too much of a perfect opportunity to take a picture of Mount Fuji there. Where am I going? Gotemba? Alright, see you Mount Fuji. I'll be riding around you the whole day, so we'll be buddies. Not playing peekaboo today. First stop, Fuji Speedway. Great day for a ride. Oh yes, look at this. Clear skies at last! I love it! it's really chilly, but it's okay. It could be raining, it could be really windy, but it's perfect. And I'm sure it's gonna warm up during the day, so this is perfect. I'm on some kind of toll road. I don't see a toll booth though. I'm sure there'll be a toll booth somewhere around here. Hopefully it has ETC. I don't want to stop. So this is Kago-Saka Tunnel. Hopefully it gets warmer in here. Woo, man. Oh, that's good, man. Nice and warm in here. Alright. So, anyway.
This guy wants me to go faster.
Okay, anyway, yeah, I'm riding through the Karbosaka tunnel right now. Oh man, I can feel it's getting colder in this. Harleys! And Mount Fuji's gone. Well, I think that means it's pretty windy here. There's a windsock. There's actual windsock on the freeway. Like, oh, hey, twisty. I like that. I like that sign. Twisty and downhill. Okay, there's a parachute on the car. That's funny. Yeah, I'm barely having the system at all right now. This particular bike that I rented comes with a GPS, a Zumo GPS. It's an okay GPS. It kind of gets me around. It kind of gets me lost in the city, but other than that, I noticed that if you want it in 3D mode, you don't want it in like whatever mode, like top down. It's harder to tell things apart, you know? There should be some kind of toll thing around here. Where the hell is it? Okay, it's ETC. Huh, that's funny. That was the ETC transponder right there. I think you can only ride it, or maybe not. $5? $5? $530 yen? Come on. Too much. Can't even go fast on this expressway, man.
Yeah.
Anyway. Motorbike. Follow. There's a military truck back there. Up there. This way. Ooh, what kind of bike is this? Be totally cut. Anyway, I'd probably do the same thing. I didn't want to ride behind the truck. Alright, where am I? I'm headed to Fuji Speedway is where I'm headed. It's to check it out, you know. It's a famous, world famous circuit. I heard they used to race the F1 here. At Fuji Speedway, but they no longer do it. But they still have lots of car events, like what's it called? GT, the JGTC Championship, the Japanese GT Championship. So, holy shit, dude! Look at that! Look at that gutter there! Oh, dude! If you or bike fell in there, you are screwed. Look at that, dude! You would be hurt badly. Look at that. That is not a good gutter to fuck around with. Woo! Dude, it's like literally, it's like up to your knee, you know? Oh man, the suspension is a little stiff right now. I think it's because it's cold. The oil on the suspension is thick. Not wanting to move so easily. Fuji no Volcan Hotel. So maybe there's probably a lot of hotels around Mount Fuji because of like people that race and stuff. You know what's funny? I never seen anybody like tow a bike around anywhere, like pickup truck or you know whatever. I'm riding through this forest here. Very nice clean road. Man, I'm going way fast over the speed limit. Very nice, a lot of nature out here, you know. Japan is a very green place. Ooh, smell it. Oh, look at that. Look at the trees. Excellent, excellent. It's kind of like a farmy area. So, I mean, that's where I would expect there to be a racetrack, right? Somewhere in the boonies where people can't complain about the noise and stuff and pollution. Oh yeah, so let me talk about hairpin turn coming up. So back there I kind of stood up because it was kind of bumpy, you know, there's like a you know, little drops and stuff in the road, and standing up on the FJ, oh man, look at that Mount Fuji, look at that view. But But yeah, so standing on the FJ is not very comfortable because your foot touches the center stand if you stand, and your foot touches the little exhaust bracket. I guess it's there to keep you from touching the exhaust with your boot, so I guess it's a good thing to have that there. But it feels weird. I don't like it. So standing on the FJ, not a good idea. Not the best thing in the world. Pretty much just have to stand if you're gonna go over something really bumpy and you don't want the bike to like get all crazy on you. Yeah, and I feel like, you know, the FJ's handling, it's a handful to get around those tight corners, you know. I know, make no mistake, it is a big bike. It is heavy. You know, once it gets moving, it's not too bad, but yeah, you really start to notice it when you get to the lower speeds, you know. I mean, it'll do just fine in traffic, just the really tight stuff, you know, like maneuvering the bike, pushing the bike around. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. And like I said, I like B-Mode the best because it has the smoothest throttle. I'm a fan of a big throttle, you know. A smooth throttle. I think I'd rather have the throttle smooth than like a really aggressive, twitchy throttle, you know. Because if I want power, I'm just gonna, you know, twist it like that, you know. I want power. Woo! Nice little road, man. There's no cops out here because I'm going like double the speed limit. As I did get pulled over earlier in this. I just accelerated out of a construction zone. Oh god, man. Yeah, this thing will get up to 100 kilometers in the blink of an eye. Especially if you're in like A mode or standard. This thing is a freaking rocket. yeah, and the cops saw that, so. I bet he didn't even know how fast I was going, you know? I don't even know if he clocked me or not, if he had a radar gun, but I think he just saw me, like, going really fast and passing cars. So, my suggestion, if you want to drive fast in Japan, just follow the cars around you. If you look like you're going about the same speed as other cars, I mean, like, yeah, that's my suggestion for, like, everywhere around the world, right? Don't look like you're going like super, super dupery fast compared relative to the traffic around you, you know? But I got pulled over for doing like 100. I must have hit 110 maybe. For like a second though. To get away from the traffic, you know? I didn't want to be around the traffic, and they were like all slowed down after a construction area. Well, you know, construction areas, slow down. Don't like fucking, don't rocket out of them because there's police there. Even America, there's police there. Okay, I think we're getting pretty close. It looks like a big clear area. Micron, treated power train. There it is! Fuji Speedway! I made it. It looks like it's closed, but I just came here just to check it out. This is the Fuji Speedway West Gate. There's a gas station here too. It looks like it may be operational. Cool, there it is. It's a world famous Fuji Speedway. Now I'm gonna go take some pictures. Maybe I'll stop over there. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like they have any events right now.